Hello, and welcome to another Lumbridge Night Guide for free-to-play OSRS. In this video, we're going to be looking at some of the best methods for training, mining, and smithing in free-to-play OSRS. So grab your hammer, grab your pickaxe, and hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to where we go. Sorry. First up, you want to head to the north of Falador and complete Doric's quest for 1.3k mining experience. This will get us from levels 1 to 10, and here's my guide on how to get this quest done. Ironmen will probably have to level their mining to mine the two iron ores required, or alternatively, they can farm dwarves in the dwarven mine. Next up, and probably one of the best quests in OSRS for a huge XP injection early on, is the Knight's Sword quest. This quest can be done with a smithing level of 1, and offers a whopping 12,725 XP, which gets us from smithing level 1 to 29 in a single beautiful hit. Once again, check out my quest guide on how to do this. For Ironmen to do this quest with a smithing level of 1, they'll need to farm dwarves in the dwarven mines or chaos dwarves in the wilderness in order to obtain the iron bars required. Lastly, you could also use the 300 XP lamp from X marks the spot. In terms of mining, there is no way to accelerate this skill using the GE. After Doric's quest, all the XP must be earned with your own bare clicks. First, I'm going to cover the general mining method to get you to the endgame, and then I'm going to look at the split between power mining, aka dropping your ore, and mining in preparation for smithing, covered in the second half of this video. This choice largely depends on if you use the GE. If not, then you should look to bank your ore. Otherwise, you can simply buy the bars needed and follow the faster method. You'll need the full set of pickaxes, starting with steel all the way up to rune. Those with access to the GE can simply buy all the picks there, while those without can buy them, excluding the black pickaxe, from the dwarven mine. The chronicle with a good number of teleports may also help depending on your circumstances, and dwarven stout can also be utilised for its plus one bonus to mining and smithing, though it's not required for the mining part of this guide. In terms of skills, 40 attack will be useful as it will allow you to wield the pickaxes and thus save an inventory space. I'm also going to assume that you've completed Doric's quest mentioned previously. With your steel pickaxe in hand then, head to your chosen mine and mine 64 of either copper or tin ore. It doesn't matter which ore or which mine because we aren't going to be banking the ore. Even those looking to bank ore for smithing should still drop the ore at this stage. When you hit a full inventory, just drop the ore on the ground. Top tip, to make this process quicker, make sure you enable the shift click to drop items option in the menu. At level 11, if you have one, switch out for your black pickaxe, then carry on mining and dropping ore until we hit level 15. Once we hit level 15, we can move on to mining iron ore. The best place to mine iron at this stage depends on if you are planning to bank the ore. If you aren't, then any mine with two iron rocks close together will do. Varrock Southwest Mine or Rimmington Mine work well. You'll need to mine 1108 iron ore to hit level 41 from level 15. If you are banking your ore, then the best spot is the Varrock Southwest Mine, which you can pair with the Chronicle to skip the return journey between the bank and the mine. Don't worry about how much iron ore you bank at this point, as we are going to mine a lot of iron going forward. Remember to upgrade your pickaxe to Mithril at 21, Adi at 31, and finally Rune at 41. We're now ready for the mining endgame. So here's where we're going to split the methods between power mining and mining ore for smithing. If you have access to the GE or are just looking to level mining as fast as possible, then this is the section for you. Those without access who need to bank ore for smithing should skip to the next section. Alcrid Mine is a well-known spot in free-to-play for power mining, and now that we can wield a rune pickaxe, we can utilise all three iron rocks. This will get you an XP rate of about 50k per hour, and can be boosted up to as high as 75k per hour using tick manipulation. I recommend a combat level of 28 to avoid the level 14 scorpions, though I think once in the correct spot, you are basically safe spotted, so it's just something to be aware of. Drop each piece you mine on the ground, and this is us to level 99. This is the best possible rate for mining in free to play. Unfortunately, however, this makes it a popular spot, so you might have to world hop in order to use it. In total, you'll need about 371k iron ores to hit 99 mining. If you're struggling to get into the spot in Alcarid, there are some alternative locations that can be used. These are either Varrock Mines, Rimmington Mine, the Dwarven Mine, or the Mining Guild once you are level 60. These are only two rock sets, though you can move between rocks to make it up to a three, and with some tick manipulation, you should be able to get rates comparable to algorithm. And that just about wraps up mining for anyone looking for the fastest possible method. Those looking to buy bars to level smithing can skip to that section now. Anyone else can check out the following sections to detail what to do if you need to bank your ore. Initially, I looked at mining coal and the various ores required to follow the plate body method of smithing. However, the mining rate is a massive factor in how fast you can smith. Consequently, I analysed the rates and did some rough calculations. As you can see, iron consistently offers the highest possible XP rate for smithing in free-to-play. This is true due to the extremely low mining rates of everything above iron. And though this doesn't count for the increased time from smithing more items, it is offset by the speed of smelting the bars, which for metals that use coal will take 2 to 4 times longer. Based on this, the best option is to mine iron in a location close to a bank. This could rule out Alcarid because the bank transition is much slower, though you can offset this by smelting the bars as you pass the furnace, similar to how I process silver in my crafting video. To do this, you should make sure you have a ring of forging equipped, and once you fill each inventory, smelt the ore on your way back to the bank. I'll look more at rings of forging in the smithing section of the video. The fastest bank transition is between the mining guild and the bank in southeast Falador. Therefore, this is the spot that I recommend you use going forward. You'll need to bank approximately 347k iron ore to hit 99 smithing with rings of forging, or double that amount without. And that's pretty much all there is to it. Bank your full inventories of iron, head back to the mine, rinse and repeat. For completion, I thought I'd add some advice on the best places to mine some of the game's other ores, starting with coal. At level 60, the mining guild is probably the best place to mine coal. It's a short walk to the southeast bank in Falador, and there's 37 rocks down there, so plenty to go around. For mithril, I'd say you can continue mining in the guild. There are 5 mithril ores there, so no need to change location, and you can use world hopping if you need to up your rate. It's the same story with adamant. There are 2 rocks in the mining guild you can use. However, given that there are only 2 rocks, you might want to try using the Bandit Camp mine northwest of the Ferox Enclave. It has 8 Addy rocks, 19 Mithril rocks, and 31 coal. The downside is obviously that it's in the wilderness, so it's very high risk for hardcore Ironmen. When it comes to rune, you have no choice but to enter the wilderness. There are only 2 rocks in free-to-play, and they are right at the back of the wilderness near the lava maze at level 46. As with all my videos, I like to add some bonus methods to offer some tips, tricks, and alternatives. The first is a couple of low click intensity AFK-ish methods. These are mining rune essence in the rune essence mines, or mining baronite shards in the Camdozal dungeon. To access these areas, you will need to complete the rune mysteries and or the below ice mountain quests. These are relatively slow methods in comparison to mining iron. I wouldn't recommend rune essence as a serious option, and for mining in Camdozal, ensure you purchase all the buffs from Romano to maximise the rate. Here you can expect around 15k per hour depending on your mining level. For anyone, especially Ironmen, crafting is a very useful skill, particularly for making money within free-to-play. I've covered crafting in a previous guide, so if anyone wants a break from grinding iron mining, you can switch out to silver and gold, as per the methods detailed in my guide. See a link on the screen now. I also haven't mentioned the soup heat item spell, which can be used to smelt bars while mining. Thus, if you're mining coal for steel bars and above, you can generate more bars per inventory and stay mining coal for longer. To maximise this method, you can combine it with the Skull Scepter, Barbarian Village Mine, and a Falador Teleport to minimise bank travel time. The Mining Guild is also a good option if you don't want to use the teleports. Finally, the last thing I'll recommend is to turn on the Runelight mining plugin to see the ore respawn timers. It's not essential, but it can be useful for planning your routes and clicks, especially if you need to decide whether to world hop or not.
Please like the video and support my content. Thank you, noble knight.
Okay, now that we've covered mining ore, we can move on to smithing some metal. Again, I'll look at the fastest method and then the manual method for those who can't use the GE. You'll need a hammer and one of two things. Either a lot of money, in the region of 230 mil coins at current prices, or a lot of iron ore and rings of forging. Outside of this, the only other requirement is to complete the Knight's Sword quest as mentioned at the start of the video. ore, and you'll also need to buy some Dwarven Stouts at level 98 to maximise XP and smith the final few Runite items. This technique is the fastest and most efficient method of training smithing in free-to-play, and essentially consists of working through each metal bracket, buying the bars required, and smithing them into the relevant plate body. For a written version, please see the OSRS wiki page. I recommend buying all the bars from the GE, and then smithing them in the forge just to the south of the Varrock West Bank. For the rest of this section, I'm going to go through each metal band, indicating how many of each metal you need to purchase, the initial cost, and any projected profit or loss. Remember, OSRS is a live marketplace, and the rates can change substantially, so check the current prices before continuing. First up, of course, is bronze. As we are already level 29 from the Knight's Sword, there isn't a huge amount of material required. Then we can move on to iron, and then steel. As I alluded to in the mining section, to mine all the coal required for the metals after iron would take an insanely long time. I think when I calculated it, it was something in the region of 732k coal to smelt the bars for this method. That's almost enough XP to hit 99 mining three times over. Ouch. Anyway, at level 68 we are finally getting into the big boys, Mithril, Adamant and Rune. You can see the number of bars required goes up exponentially, but also once you hit Addy, in the current market, you'll start to turn a profit. When you hit 98 smithing, you will need to go and get a fair amount of Dwarven Stouts from the pub in Falador. This will raise your smithing to 99 and allow you to make rune plate bodies. However, instead of making rune plate bodies, make rune plate skirts. It's pretty much identical in terms of the total number of bars required, but instead of losing 77 mil, you'll make 5.7 mil. A worthwhile swap in my book. Just remember, like I said at the start of the section, check the market rates to help you decide what to smith. Equally, I wouldn't bother looking to make a profit on anything below Mithril, as any profits will be small and the time invested may be significant. Time for the non-GE method. Following completion of the Knight's Sword, we will be level 29. We need to get to level 33 in order to start smithing iron plate bodies, which we are going to do all the way up to level 99. This means we are going to need a total of about 347k iron bars, which will give us approximately 69k iron plate bodies. On top of this, we will need 2,481 rings of forging. Iron Men can get these by making ruby rings or buying them from Grum's Gold Exchange in Port Sarum, then speaking to Murky Matt at the GE and paying him 250 coins to enchant. This will require about 620k. You can follow this method without the rings and it will still be the fastest, however you will need double the amount of iron ore, so it will literally take you twice as long. First up, we need to smelt that iron ore into iron bars. This will get us from level 29 to about 87. Edgeville is the best spot to do this as it's the closest bank to a furnace, so unless you've already smelted your ore from mining using the Alcarid method, you best get your smelt on and smelt all 347k bars. Obviously you don't have to do this all in one go. We all know the dangers of burnout. You can periodically stop and smith your bars into iron plate bodies. Initially, you will need to smelt at least 440 to get from 29 to 33, but from then on, you're golden. I recommend using the anvil in Varrock next to the West Bank, as this seems to be the closest anvil to a bank in free-to-play. Also, remember to sell your iron plate bodies to Horvick in Varrock for a good price. And yeah, that pretty much covers the best smithing options in free-to-play. Just before we close this video down, there are a couple of additional methods. The first up is essentially what we just covered in the manual smithing method. I am referring to the process of smithing bars. The reason I mention it again is because smelting bars is a lot more AFK than smithing plate bodies and can allow you to level your account in the background or on your mobile while you do other things. Silver and iron are the best ores for this, and you can turn a small profit buying these ores and selling the bars. Lastly, we are back in the ruins of Comdozal. This time we are focusing on crushing Baronite deposits, which gets you 30 smithing XP per deposit. Your best pickaxe and a hammer is all you need, and once you have a full inventory of deposits, you can go break them open. The XP rate is pretty low, so it's not a method I would recommend, but if you want to do something that's a combination of AFK mining and smithing, then maybe this is the one. I do love the aesthetic of this dungeon. And that brings us to the end of this video. Whichever method you choose to follow, I wish you the best of luck. Please leave a comment if you have any hints, tips and tricks of your own, as I'm keen to hear them. And all that's left for me to say is, I've been the Lumbridge Knight, peace out and thanks for watching.